Imagine that you have a system of some particles that move according to the forces that act on them. For more than two particles, this is really hard to calculate. In those cases, it would be easier to investigate how the system as a whole moves. Let's say we are not interested in knowing how exactly each and every single particle moves, but rather whether all of them, together, move up, down, left, or right. In those cases, we introduce the center of mass coordinate. Let's start with a simple definition. We define the total mass of the system as the sum over I of all individual masses. This sum goes from 1 to n, depending on how many particles we have. In our example, n is equal to 3. Now we can define the most important quantity of this video, the center of mass coordinate. In the denominator, you can recognize the total mass of the system, which means we can also write it like this. So how does the center of mass move? According to Newton's laws, m times the second derivative of x is equal to the forces that act on the center of mass. But what are those forces? Let's go back to the individual particles once more. Every single particle fulfills this equation of motion. Note that we separated the forces acting on the particle into internal and external forces. An internal force is a force that acts between two of the particles. Let's assume that the one on the top is positively charged and the other two are negatively charged. Plus and minus will attract, whereas same charges will tend to move away from each other. The notation here is such that F13 denotes the force that is acting on particle 1 and was caused by particle 3. It is important to realize that because of Newton's third law, Fij is equal to minus Fji. That's why, for instance, F23 and F32 point in exactly opposite directions but have the same magnitude. And since F11 should be equal to minus F11, it's always zero. A particle does usually not apply a force on itself. If there is also an electric field present, then all of the particles will feel another force, which has nothing to do with them, but comes from an external source. Positively charged particles will get pushed in the direction of the electric field, and negatively charged particles in the other direction. These forces are called external forces. So now that we theoretically know how every particle moves, let's go back to the center of mass. A trick to do this is to sum this equation over all I. On the left side, we can write the time derivative outside of the summation symbol, since the masses are a constant in time. On the right-hand side, we investigate the internal forces a bit closer. If we write the first few terms, we see that all of them vanish. The 1, 2, 2, and so on terms are zero by themselves, and every 1, 2 term has a 2, 1 term, which together cancel each other. We finally get back to our equation of motion for the center of mass coordinate, and see that the relevant forces are only the external ones. The center of mass motion is not affected by any internal forces between the particles. Instead, we can pretend that there is only one particle of mass m that moves around however the external forces push or pull on it. So that's pretty much it for this video. Thanks for watching.